some of the influences of secularism. Let's just call these logs that ignite
logs
the
that
fire.
Ignites the fire.
You, the first thing you had was the Isley brother said, "In between the sheets, doom."
Now that was Ron Isley's my music teacher
for all day. We, you talking about Mr. Big? Mr. Big said first he started with "In between the sheets," then he got contagious. He came into the house and heard that boom, boom, boom. See, that would have been enough for me, right? I don't even need to hear the moan. That bed hit, and I ain't in it.
You come home
and hear boom, boom, boom.
Something's gone. I had to go up the stairway. All I hear is my baby's voice screaming.
I could not. Not my baby's voice,
bruh.
Mm-mm. With the boom, boom, boom too.
The streets said there'd be no ransom in that day. There'll be no conversation. All you brothers, listen to me. I got a 9mm Smith & Wesson. I got a Glock and a Mossberg. Stay out my yard, brother.
But before I go right there, let me say this. I had this conversation in the break room at work.
Yeah.
On what you just said. I had to share it with a Mexican fella. He said,
go ahead.
He said, because I'm going to hit you right where you said. Then we go with Usher said, making love in the club, in the club. In
we making love in the club.
Because when we used to grow up in the club, well, we didn't club, we house party.
Yeah.
We went to skating and all that type of, nobody made love in it. We did a couple doing the butts and stuff like that. And shake your ink, your thing. But now, they making love in the club. Women are grinding on women. Dudes are standing on the wall looking at women pull the hands of another chick and get out on the floor. Brothers is out on the floor that is getting action with the women with no drawers on. Bruh. Literally sexing and folks is recording stuff now.
Bruh, when Tupac called that rape case, he said when he met her that on the dance floor, she went down on him and gave him fellatio.
Yeah.
In front of everybody.
It's too norm now, brother. The dude at a sex joint, I was looking at on the internet, a Mexican at a strip joint got a lap dance from a woman, but literally took his stuff out and she literally let him, had sex there, and everybody in the strip joint was clubbing, feminine, until the bouncer seen it and kicked him out. It was ended up in a big brawl in it, but it was there getting filmed, brother, in the club, in the strip joint. It's literal now. Here's the sad part. I won't even leave that. Hey, what's the church? What happened in the church, brother?
It was a pastor.
Not another pastor.
It was a pastor. It's a lot of African pastors that's kind of doing the most.
I bet.
He's in the back of the church.
Witch doctor.
Doing some young lady. and she filmed it.
I've seen that.
She filmed it and...
I've seen that.
Bruh. This joint, I'm thinking.
I'm thinking,
you know, they're gonna show the clip. I'm thinking they're gonna. They show he.
Yeah.
Bouncing her, man.
And she had a bouncy.
Yeah.
Yeah, bro. Go ahead. This pastor. He this said she pastor. Told him to do that.
Yeah.
She gave him the permit to go ahead.
Bruh.
I seen that. White House with
Bill Clinton.
What'd he do? What didn't he do?
I did not have sex with that woman. Yes, you did.
Sexual relations.
I didn't have sexual relations with that woman. Yes, you did.
If you didn't, she for dang sure had him with you. Under the desk.
And was blackballed for 15 some years.
Mm.
And she just now, last year, coming out with a story about what happened. She was an intern. He been having sex with her.
That's right, man. Bro, that ain't nothing. You just got caught this time. It ain't the first time it happened. This is the first time you got caught. Say it like it really is. Humpty said, I once had sex.
In a Burger King bathroom.
In a Burger King bathroom. We got busy in a Burger King bathroom. This is the same guy that said, yeah, we the freaks of the industry.
Freaks of the industry.
I mean, doom, da, doom,
doom, doom, doom. He said, do what you like.
Do what you like. I mean, it's just you like. He said, what's the pickle? Because in the 60s, now my Humpty knows to tickle your rear. My nose is big. He said, I'm not ashamed. Big like a pickle. And I still get paid. I get paid.
Made by the ladies. You know I'm in charge.
What is it? Broke, living in the Lord. Something like that. He's still telling you. He gets stupid. He knows how to
do it. At a 69, my big nose is
tickle your rear. That's it. He said, Humpty was telling him just where he was. His nose is big. Nah, he not ashamed, boy. Big.
And he was literal. He said, I literally had sex in the Burger King bathroom. That's what he was working at.
He meant everything he said. Do what you like. We already talked about Janet. Janet told him, she started out innocent and said, let's wait a while. That's what she said. Before it's too late, let's wait a while. Then she went ahead and answered it and told him, someday is tonight. which you heard the other night. Someday is tonight.
I ain't never heard that song.
Boy, in the you talking about moaning and groaning on the song.
Come on, man.
Doom, doom, doom. Then she cleaned it up and said, we gonna making love in the rain. Man, anytime.
That's any place.
Logs thrown into the fire to anticipate the combustion, brother.
Miss Jackson.
If you're nasty.
I'm gonna read this one. We're gonna sign up. We're gonna pick back up. This is a series.
It's a series, that's right. It's
of the burning bed.
Gonna be a good series. We just painting the canvas right now, because it's gonna go get thicker as we go.
I looked at Backdraft.
Okay, that's cool.
Backdraft is a phenomenon in which a fire that has consumed all the available oxygen suddenly explodes when more oxygen is made available.
Mm-hmm.
Typically because a door or a window has been opened.
Mm.
The scripture talks about in the book of Job how a strong wind from the wilderness mm-hmm. came and blew down his children's house and killed him.
Mm-hmm.
Doors and windows. All it takes is a little leaven.
Mm-hmm. That's right. 11 a whole lump, brother.
And 11 at the whole lump. All you need is a little crack. When you talk about that pastor,
mm-hmm.
he had the knowledge to know that he was supposed to do.
He did. Put his head on the lap.
But he had been feeding
that fire. With little logs.
Feeding that fire. You know that conversation was gangster. They weren't talking about the Beatitudes.
No.
They weren't talking about Lamentations.
No.
They were talking about in between the sheets.
That's what they were talking. Footsteps in the dark.
And whatsoever man thinketh in his heart,
that's what
so
he is.
He. Mm-hmm. What he meditated on was burning in lust.
Yep.
He seen it. He pictured it. He manifested it. And it cost him something.
It cost him his soul, his life. I don't know if it cost him his soul, but if a dang show cost him his life, brother.
David said, no evil will I look upon because that's a door.
Mm-hmm.
Scripture says, corrupt communication doth mess up
good
manners.
It do.
The scripture says, touch not the unclean thing. We talk about the three things that we feed this mm-hmm. unquenchable, this insatiable, mm-hmm. this unstoppable, inordinate, relishing,
immoral,
deprived, lustful,
degrading,
appetite for destruction,
because that's
called
what
lust.
Because that's what it is. I know it feels good to us. And
come on.
We it's hard to fight all these curves and all this sexual temptation and this intimacy because we like the person we with and we horn in, our hormones raging, and we got all this sexual dances and all this stuff that intensifies and combusts what we're burning in. But the Bible says that the eyes of a man are never satisfied.
Come on.
So is hell and destruction.
Come on.
Never fool.
Come on.
So we just got to look at the eyes being the window.
Come on.
To the what?
To the soul.
That's what the eyes is. It's a window to the soul. We gonna pause here because this is a series and we ain't gonna flamboy and bombard it with everything because we gonna take our time and walk through this.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We want you to hear from two men. And two saved men.
Come on.
And two saved men with lust they've had in their life and lust that God has restrained.
Yes.
And lust that we have and continually yielding to God with.
And have to continually yield to God
with.
There's no sense of arrival. There's no apprehension. It's
every day crucifying the flesh.
Doors that you open, you have to be a watchman.
Daily.
It's called governing yourself.
That's right.
Stewarding yourself. And we, you know, we like to have fun and everything, but we're going to give our brothers and sisters some tools.
Yeah.
On how to win.
How to win. We just paint the canvas.
Come on.
We loosen it up. We let our hair down because we know these are touchy subjects.
Yes, sir.
And people who don't want to really receive it thinks it's a judgmental, blasphemous that you're writing off it. But no, we're talking straight reality.
Yes.
To what you, and then at the same time, we're not going to leave nobody hanging. We want to help benefit. We want folks to understand that there is sexual relations done the right way.
Come on.
To where God can fulfill it. If you, and I know it's a process and God don't move as quick as it was taking, so I gotta get mad at. We know it's two flip sides, but we're gonna cover all that stuff because the flip side with God is eternal rest. This quick, instant, microwave passion of burning can be a one day, 1 minute great demise.
Come on.
I'd rather take my chances on trying to do it the right way after so long.
Come on, because a minute of pleasure
can be a lifetime
of destruction
and consequences.
We love you. This is Elder Walt.
This is Elder Fred Williams.
See you in the next episode.
Alrighty.